New information tonight about a mysterious condition called Morgellons that's affecting more than 100 people in South Texas.
Ten Five first brought you the story in May of this bizarre disease that makes people's skin crawl. Nobody knows how you get it, really. Now the Centers for Disease Control in Atlanta is launching a study that could target Texas. Tonight, Eyewitness News anchor Deborah Knapp travels to Ground Zero in the battle to uncover the truth about Morgellons.
You feel some kind of crawling sensation right around the lesion.
Cindy Casey suffers from Morgellons. It has bizarre symptoms, lesions that leave scars, the sensation of bugs crawling under the skin, and the most shocking, fibers that pop out of the skin.
Mostly black and white. Some of them are blue and some of them are red.
These are Cindy's lesions at their worst. Like others, she was diagnosed with delusional parasitosis, delusions of parasites. Most doctors don't recognize this as a disease, but one medical school is taking Morgellons very seriously.
It is here at the Oklahoma State University Center for Health Sciences that most of the Morgellons research is being done. Doctors and scientists here say this disease is very real and it's frightening.
I am 100% convinced that Morgellons is a real disease. Pathology.
Dr. Randy Wymore has spent the past year studying hundreds of fibers from Morgellons patients.
The samples do, in fact, look very similar to one another.
And Dr. Wymore says they don't look like anything found in textiles. And they're not rubbing off from clothing because doctors here have found the fibers inside the body.
We were even able to observe fibers under completely unbroken skin.
There's no question in my mind it's a real disease.
Dr. Rhonda Casey has examined more than 30 Morgellons patients.
You can see the fiber completely beneath the skin.
She extracts this fiber from under the skin, and here's what it looks like under a microscope.
I think if it weren't for the fibers, the patients would all be taken very seriously. So I think even though the fibers may be a key to having us diagnose this disease, they have also been a hindrance to it even being accepted as a real disease in the past.
Doctors have discovered less visible symptoms, nerve and neurological damage.
Trouble concentrating, trouble communicating, and problems thinking of the words that you want to say and how you want to express yourself.
But it is the symptoms that sound like science fiction that makes this disease like no other.
I pulled some fibers out, and I was just taking a look at it, and the fibers just started to move around, kind of around each other. And I screamed at Charles. Charles, come here and look. Says, you know, here I went. Everybody's been telling me I'm crazy. Charles, look at this. And he looked at it, and yeah, he saw it too.
That's what I didn't want to believe.
One more bizarre part to this puzzling disease that seems to be spreading.
There is a slightly frightening component to it that we don't know what causes this. If more and more people are coming down with Morgellons, we need to get a handle on this. Is there an environmental component that needs to be addressed? Is it contagious? Well, these are all things we really don't know the answer to at this point.
The CDC has formed a task force to investigate Morgellons, and they're launching a study to find out where this condition is most common and who it affects. Texas is one of the states with the most cases, and the epidemiology study may be conducted here. And the CDC has set up an email address for questions because of the volume of calls following our reports in May. That address is MorgellonsSyndrome@cdc.gov. We'll continue to follow this and keep you informed. Deborah Knapp, Ken Five, Eyewitness News.
You may wonder why you haven't heard about this elsewhere. It's because we're way ahead on this story. In a few more weeks or months, the networks and the New York Times will start writing stories about it. Then, boom, it'll be everywhere. Anyway, for more on Morgellons and to hear unedited interviews, head to the Ken's Five website, mysa.com.